This is tough because now, again, what we've heard over and over and over is we're beginning to talk about sex. When I realized I was going to have to do this, you know, it wasn't easy. This wasn't something I had ever done in my nursing career. So I made a point to practice. My nursing educators had always told me, you got something tough, practice. Every night after dinner, I went into the bathroom. I talked to the mirror about sex. My husband, a black Labrador retriever, Lucy, stood outside and wondered if I had lost my mind or what was wrong with my mental health that every night after dinner, I have to talk about sex. And let me tell you, the first two times that I got up in front of a group like you and tried to do it, it wasn't easy, okay? So it's what you've heard this morning. Practice makes perfect. And what else is very important is what you say to the patients hits home, okay? When you tell them that it's important, when you tell them that you can talk to them about this, you have just opened a door that is going to help them to better health, and that's just all there is to it. And then there was Sister Dolores, the Catholic nun that I worked with for over 20 years. And Sister Dolores is what we heard this morning from Tim, got better evaluations on sex ed than I did in all of our trainings. It used to frost me. So one night on the way home, I say to Dolores in the dark, and we did a four-hour lecture in Rehoboth, and we're driving home, and I think I won't blush. Dolores, how come you get better evaluations on sex ed than me? I'm a nurse, and you're a Catholic nun. She, oh, honey, that's easy. As a nun, I've had none. You have embarrassing memories. So don't ever underestimate where your best help may come from, okay? Don't ever underestimate. Now, here's where I get nervous, because I'm hoping when I press on this, we're going to go into the internet. And I don't know what Tim's... I can do my own? Okay. I think, oh, I'm going to love him for forever. Okay, so you need to go on to the Delaware HIV Consortium website. This website is fantastic for patients or prospective PrEP users, but you're not going to get the prescriber there at least yet, okay? So then if you scroll down, oh, this is so cool. You're going to see over here, PrEP education, and you press on there, and there we go. So we have PrEP for you, the general information, PrEP for prescribers, and PrEP with the Delaware News. So if we go into the prescribers, the first thing you're going to see is the fact sheet, okay? Cool. They gave you a bunch of them, okay? And you can download this, and as I said, put it in your offices, put it in your treatment rooms, and hand that out to patients. And even if you think it may be too hard, don't underestimate our patients, okay? I would hand it to them. And I think even maybe some of the adolescents, I would even try to give some, oh golly, some information to them. Now that's the other one. Oh. Hold on. Yeah. Uh-huh. Oh, there. Okay. Okie doke. And see, if I keep doing this, you'll all have this down by the time you get home. Okay. The next one are the clinical, the risk assessment tool, okay? And that is excellent. It's actually adapted, and we've seen that a couple times, and we know our author is right here. So all you have to do is go on and print this out. And again, I would give this to patients and let them, as we heard this morning, either fill it out in the waiting room or you can read it to them. Again, if you have a score of 10 or greater, you need to evaluate the person for PrEP. And if it's less than 10, you may look at other preventive services. But you don't have to wade through and look for this. It's right there and you can download it and you'll be in really good shape, okay? The next is probably one of my favorites. And that was Dr. Cajal's interpretation. So she took the 67-page guidelines, and she actually created just a wonderful 6-page tool. The thing that I like best about the 6 pages is page 5. And that's where you'll find, and this is probably something I would put on the wall, you'll find the actual algorithm that she's written, what the baseline visit would look like, one calendar week from testing, the follow-up, 30 days from prep initiation, 60 days later, and then she's listed your labs. And this is just incredibly beautiful, and as I said, it's 6 pages. It is just a wonderful resource. So I would strongly advise you to go into the website and download that one. We also have frequently asked questions. We have a fact sheet for patients. We have some discussion on sexual history. And again, I really believe that we as providers, if we can open that door, and what I heard Linda Dean say this morning, you know, sometimes my patients were my best teachers in the beginning because I didn't know what kinds of sex people were having. And sometimes my patients were so willing to actually teach me and to help me and get me along the way. I've actually had recently in the last month, 3 providers say to me, I need help with this. And I'm going to go to their office. I'm going to take scripts. I'm going to help them with that. How to take a sexual history. It is so important. It is so very, very important. And again, once we say to our patients, you know, I'm willing to talk to you about this, the next thing that happens is they feel comfortable with us and we can make a difference in their lives. Now, the one thing that we haven't seen, which again is another Dr. Cahill's beautiful invention, is the PrEP home checklist. And this is something we can give to patients. And it tells, I mean, it just makes it transparent for the patients. So this you can download. It's 7 pages. Do it back to back. You'll have like 3.5 pages. But it's beautiful. It shows the patients what's going to be done, when it's going to be done, what's going to be expected of them. And fortunately, we have patients who still work and work full-time jobs. So this will help them be able to plan their lives. When are they going to need to get labs? When are they going to need to see the doctor? And we can, as I said, we can actually download this and give it to them, and they can take it home, and they will know what is expected of them, and nothing could be better. There is a Truvada fact sheet, okay? And then all the clinical trials are here. I don't know about you, but that might be a good sleep aid for some of us. I'm not sure. Okay. And then other resources, the National Resource Center, Project Inform, a current list of, again, the PrEP providers in Delaware. And I think it's really, really important that we be able to find that. Okay. Now, PrEP for You. Okay, so this is section 1. And again, you can find that here, or you can find it with the consortium's list. So general information about PrEP. And it's beautifully done. It's done in English and it's done in Spanish. And again, you can download those and take them out. You know, are you ready for PrEP? So that's this brochure. So if you run out of them, you can download them and copy them and put them in. But you can request these from the consortium. If you want me to come out and do any work with you, I'll be glad to come and I'll be glad to bring some of these materials with me if you want more. Okay? Okay. Then getting yourself prepared. This is Project Inform. And for many of you who've had many questions about how to fund this, how to get money, how to get the prescriptions written, there's some good guidelines on here. This is going to take a little while, looks like. And, oh, come on. That's got to be one you're going to have to look at when you get home, I'm afraid. Okay, but it is very good. There's 5 steps about how to talk to your provider, what you do to get your prescriptions, where you go for your prescriptions, how you pay for your prescriptions, and it's just a beautiful chart, and you could, again, put that up in any of your clinic areas or your doctor's offices, and it would be fabulous for the patients to see. And then questions about PrEP. And again, if you Google toolkits, you'll find many, many, many toolkits, okay? But these are just wonderful resources. And again, the committee that we've worked on has spent many, many hours making sure that these resources are good and that it will help you. And so in case you as a provider aren't comfortable talking to your patient, we encourage our patients to be willing to ask you, can you talk to them about their sexual? And I heard it again this morning, you know, I'm really lucky. My primary health care provider has an electronic medical record, and she puts the recommendations in there. So when I show up under 64 and I haven't had an HIV test, she tells me I'm going to have an HIV test. When I show up and she tells me I'm a baby boomer because I was born between 1945 and 1965, I'm going to have a hepatitis C test. She has it in her electronic medical record, which is really helpful. So again, if you can get any of these recommendations, any of these guidelines into your electronic medical record, it will help you immensely. Okay, and the list of prescribers in Delaware, and you can see there are about 10, and then you can see some centers actually have more than one provider listed, which is extremely good because it gives you lots of, and there are, it looks pretty good for downstate too because we have a few. I think Sussex County probably is the one place that we really need to find a prescriber, and so we'll be working on that for sure. And then the Gay Men's Health Crisis, okay, is a wonderful resource. And that's going to load quick. Their toolkit is also excellent, and I would strongly advise you to take a look at that. There, as I said, you can find many, many, many toolkits, okay, but there are a few that are better than others, and this is one that I would strongly recommend. But being from Delaware, if you need help, I would definitely go to the consortium's website, and I would definitely use our toolkit. There are blogs, there are testimonials, there's all kinds of videos, and again, there's information about Truvada. Gilead has put wonderful fact sheets about the medication out there for us. Oh, I can't believe we got through that. Okay. So again, just to review quickly, Section 1, general information, includes a list of all the prescribers in Delaware. I would encourage you, if you become a prescriber, call the consortium and get your name on that list. This is, again, the breakdown of every component of Section 1, and additional resources are excellent there. Again, Section 2 is for the prescribers, and remember that the protocol is only 7 pages long. Remember that there's a home checklist for the patients, and remember there's information on how to begin to take a sexual history. And again, if we can come out and provide individual education for you on any of these issues or topics, we'd be glad to do that. And then Section 3 is PrEP news. And again, I think this is a good reason to go in and check the website at least on a monthly basis. It does give you a list of when the advisory committee meetings are. And again, if you have some issue coming up that you'd like us to address, find out when the next meeting is, get to one of us. It did advertise today's summit. I'm very lucky. I get to travel and I get to do lectures outside of Delaware. I always like to take a little piece of Delaware with me when I go. And this was a bulletin board that was kind of all over the state a few years ago. It was done by the Adolescent Pregnancy Group. So I like to take this and say, if Delaware is a very conservative little state, but we can put up billboards like this, even your state can do it. That's all there is to it. There was a little 8-year-old boy early on, and he said the greatest gift he got was when somebody wasn't afraid to touch him. And I think that a lot of times that's the bottom line. We went into this to help people, and sometimes we touch them in different ways, but sometimes a hug, a handshake, just looking them in the eyes and being real respectful is one of the best things that we ever do. So Lucy, the Black Labrador Retriever, and I would like to go for a walk this afternoon. So I'm going to make this real short. She would tell you, put on a good sunscreen. Maybe you even go to Walgreens or someplace good to buy that. Okay, there's lots of places you can go buy sunscreen. But Lucy would tell you to go buy a good sunscreen and go out and sit in the sun and boost your immune system. Do anything you can to take care of yourself and your community to make Delaware a better place. I can't thank you enough, and thanks to Scott and to the consortium, Public Health, Planned Parenthood, Westside Health. Oh, I'm forgetting somebody, but thank you all.